When our immune system is working properly, it responds and attacks foreign viruses and bacteria. But in the case of a so-called autoimmune disease, the immune system begins to attack its own body instead. Examples of this are type 1 diabetes, when the immune system attacks the production of insulin, or arthritis, when it starts to break down the body's tendons and joints. Among the lesser-known autoimmune diseases, there is Addison's disease, for example, when the adrenal glands are attacked and prevented from producing the vital hormones cortisol and aldosterone. And if Addison's disease is not detected in time, it will lead to death. Is it possible to stop this Addison's disease and all other autoimmune diseases? That is the hope of Olle Kämpe, who today is a research doctor at the Karolinska Institute, but who once was a student who felt that this research was probably so difficult that he would never be able to handle it.
Actually thought I was a bit stupid and not fit for doing science.
But it was good. Many people would probably say today that Olle continued on to do research because he has a lot of things going on and has already helped many people.
Ja, hej Eva.
Hej.
Vilka bekymmer har du idag?
Ja, bekymret är med medicineringen, men så är det ju alltid med alla. Att det är bekymmer med medicineringen.
Eva has one of the 300 or so autoimmune diseases known to date. Olle is looking for something that can stop these from breaking out in the first place. It is specifically Addison's disease that Eva has.
Jag blev utmattad av den minsta lilla ansträngning. Det var första tecknet. Och sen började jag kräkas på morgnarna. Och i början så var det någon gång bara sporadiskt. Och då tänkte jag, det var väl för att jag tog för mycket vin igår. Eller det var väl för att jag åt något fel. Och sen blev jag så sjuk så att jag var tvungen att åka till akuten. Och där höll jag på att stryka med faktiskt.
In order to find the common basic mechanism which triggers autoimmune diseases, Olle and the team use technology to search in every place imaginable, such as in the patient's inner tissue, in their genes, in the proteins that the genes code for. Because it's not easy to find out what has happened when the immune system has gone haywire.
No, we don't know what initiates the autoimmune reaction. What we know is that it starts several years before the patients come to clinical care. So we come to the scene of the crime too late, and we want to understand what happened several years earlier. And that is not so easy.
Nevertheless, Olle has some clues that he's tracking down. In the 90s, he led his group to the discovery that the immune system in all patients with Addison's disease reacted to the very same substance, the enzyme 21-hydroxylase. Since then, the enzyme has been used as a warning signal. If doctors suspect that a patient has Addison's disease, they can test for the enzyme and identify the disease before the patient dies. The basic research, Olle says, constantly produces positive side effects. He and the team are currently working on a promising treatment for patients with Addison's who have also developed an autoimmune reaction against their ovaries so that they can still get pregnant. And so Olle's group, in collaboration with Umeå University Hospital, has produced something so simple and effective as this card.
Well, this is an emergency card for patients with adrenal insufficiency, Addison's disease. And this is used all over Europe today and look exactly the same.
Jag har räddat många liv. Jag har räddat mitt liv ett par gånger faktiskt. Så är det. Min dröm skulle ju vara att jag på något sätt kunde bli frisk och bli fri från det här Addisons sjukdom som är en plåga varje dag. Men sen är det ju viktigt för alla som drabbas. För det är ju många som har kanske 4, 5, 6 olika autoimmuna sjukdomar. Och de har inte det lätt.
Det skulle kunna vara det eftersom det är en hypotyreos också. Och sen har han en syster som har...
Olle believes that what starts Addison's autoimmune disease might be something so small that it is difficult to detect.
It might be something just as easy as a virus, and it might be something banal, like an eye infection.
A perfectly harmless little eye virus, which goes away without us even thinking about it, Olle believes could cause the start of a cross-reaction with 21-hydroxylase, so that the immune system runs amok and causes Addison's disease. If this would be so, a vaccine could be given against the virus so that Addison's wouldn't have to occur. And if Olle's team finds such a basic solution, it could be used to stop many other autoimmune diseases as well, such as arthritis and type 1 diabetes.
I think we will understand much more about autoimmunity in the future, and I hope that will lead to treatments that will prevent, if not all, but the majority of autoimmunity.